crap. Ugh. Yeah. Goodbye, cruel world. So, yeah. No good. So I'm gonna go through all that again. I think if we made a different choice. We would have been able to, not have to fight this fight. We were able to talk him out of it. But I think he got so pissed by what we did with Choi. He just wanted to fight us, or maybe... Maybe it's the choices at the end. Maybe the choices within the mirror didn't matter. It was more the choices at the end. You know, after the dialogue at the end. He didn't like that I was asking him more questions or something like that. Apparently, because once I said I wanted to ask him more questions, that was it. I'm like, okay, battle. So, you need to go through all that again and see what happens. Okay. I did everything over again. I've gone through the mirror and everything. I'm pretty darn sure I chose all the same options as last time. So that the let's play makes sense to people watching, most of all. And to be true to the whole story progression and all that. Okay, don't ask him more questions. Inifere, you need to close the gate. Now, before they take control of you. Your brother nods. This place has brought but woe and false hope. Let it go.
I'll remember that.
Inifere seals his eyes shut and begins to howl. You see the world about you shifting and churning. Everything goes dark and empty, save for voices almost as soft as silence itself. Ooh, we're loading an area. So I guess we made it without fighting him. And it's closed.
Listen to me, dear. I must tell you something.
Okay. Somehow, Inifere's decision to close the gate forces you back outside. Inifere is gone. There's no telling where, but the gate has closed behind you. Without the gate, the cultists have no reason to kill anymore. Or less reason, at least. You're not the only thing that has been expelled from the gate. A small pile of objects lies at your feet. Sweet. A new reflection is forming in the labyrinth. We got goods. We can all level up. We'll accept Eretus.
All right.
And she wants to talk to us. I got 80 shins. An impossible blade. Wow. And an enigmatic sphere. As you pick up the small, plain obsidian sphere, it turns a frosted white and changes size to fit comfortably in the palm of your hand. Marked with fine lines in all directions, it is smooth and cool to the touch, and extremely light. When you heft it around in your hand, however, you notice that its weight seems to temporarily increase as more momentum is applied to it. Wow. Temporarily. And an impossible blade. 7 relativistic damage, which ignores resistance. +3 damage per effort applied to a max of +12. I think the one I bought for Eretus is even better, though. One glance at this weapon serves as an explanation of its name, as the blade is of an impossible thinness. A trans-dimensional energy field generated by a device in its short handle maintains the blade's structural integrity. And as such, the blade can't be used when this field is not powered, as it would shatter on the slightest impact. Well, I'm assuming let's make sure it's always powered. But maybe our other friend can use it. I just want to compare here. I can't do anything with this, so I guess we'll sell it. Where's this blade? I can't. I want to do the compare. This does 8 physical. That's 7 relativistic. Which I guess could be even better because you can resist this damage. And critical hits though. 7 versus 8. Yeah. He's got a pretty good sword. He's got 10 physical damage and 10 energy. I'll think about it for him. Well, we can level up people. Increase stat heals. Mate. Speed. Abilities. Yeah, he already had this stuff. Okay. Eretus does not lead to level up soon, though. He just needs 16 XP. Calistige. Ability or a skill? How about ability? Entropic field. Only usable during combat. On hit, confers vulnerable armor reduction. You create an energy siphoning vortex, weakening all within its radius. None can stand before you. Alright, so this is a debuff spell. We got flash, which I think she has, doesn't she? And gravity manipulation. Yeah, she has these abilities. They're just... If I increase them, they'll become more powerful. Flash. Oh, I can only choose one? I haven't even used this yet, that's why I'm not choosing that.
A worthy goal.
Oh, good. I'm glad you agree. Now I can increase an ability or a skill. Add your stat pool. Let's choose... See, I have all these to choose from. I have complete inability in deception. And I guess... Yeah, I can't even train medium or heavy weapons. Because I'm a nano. Oh, anamnesis we need.
I understand now.
Good. Because not knowing some of these things, or not knowing anamnesis, is kind of limiting us. Because she wants to talk about stuff. Oh, look at that, the little talking thing.
I find it hard to believe that Inifere could live within that hellscape for as long as he did. What was he fleeing that was so much more terrible than where he was?
I love when we have lines of, like, you know, spoken lines here. They come way too seldom, for my liking. What was he fleeing? Well, he's probably hiding from the sorrow. Think so? He was hiding from the sorrow. The sorrow could not possibly compare with what we saw beyond the gate. She shakes her head. In all realities, there is nothing like it. And where it is, there is only the one gate, snuffing out possibilities wherever, or forever. He may not even be the same Inifere who originally went in. She shrugs. But we all deal with that uncertainty from time to time. Worse than the sorrow, huh? She thinks, after all, which one of us is the real Canastige? Is there one even? I wonder if anyone has any other insights on Aratus. Nope.
Yes, lad.
Oh, is it time for talking again? Oh wait, let me just see. Probably just fine. Yeah. Okay, so only she's had something to say about all this. Which is fine, I guess. Alright, I need to go back and rest. I closed the gate. Hopefully the cultists will stop bothering you soon. Truly. Her face becomes full of light. Thank you, madame. Thank you. Both the living and the dead are forever in your debt.
Making a note.
I regret I have nothing to give you. We do not have much in the way of personal possessions. However, there is one who might. Ronos Cai'sul. He likes to collect odd relics from the alcoves outside. He would be more than happy to reward you on our behalf, I'm sure, if he has anything to give. Seek him out in the valley. Gonna rest. Free rest. There you go. If anyone else has anything to say. Then let's go speak with Ronos.
Here comes the boredom slayer.
We can sell a bunch of useless items too, and see if we can buy anything else. Okay. All right. Did I just sell him that? Not sure. Battle axe. I wanted to sell it anyway. Just Where's that one sword? Oh, I gave it to... I gave it to him. All these daggers and battle axes. We got lots of money now. Pretty sweet. Okay. Is he selling anything we need? Intellect, yeah. We do need that. And spray flesh. Fleetfoot moss. I have these. I haven't healed Might yet, so I'm just not going to buy any. Okay.
I'm ready. I'm always ready.
Oh, wait a second. This one's faster. Talk to Ronos. Keep checking Beltrax to see if there's anything new with him. And there isn't. Choice thoughts jangle about in your head as you stand before this man who calls himself Ronos Cai'sul. She starts with alienation and rage at this theft of her father's self, but with the fickle speed of youth her heart changes, thudding along until it reaches its ultimate conclusion, that this is how the world reworks itself and tries again, like a child kneading clay between her fingers and dreaming of all it can be. Then you're alone again in your mind. His eyes alight when he sees your return. The children of the Endless Gate have curtailed their activities, and I have no doubt it was due to your actions. He presses a device into your hands. Please, take this as a token of our gratitude. We didn't even have to ask. Making a note. Brace of the mighty Calastor. Truly, I don't know what brought you to the valley, friend, but we are all grateful that you came. Is there anything else I can do for you? I guess that's it. Farewell. Alright, well there it is. I just have to... Alright. Bonded item artifact. Plus one might edge. Plus one damage per effort applied. Max plus six on esoteric attacks. Oh, negative one, negative two might pool. I guess it's alright. When this synth device is put on, it suffuses the wearer with physical energy flowing throughout the body, radiating inwards to reinforce blood flow and energy resources. The device utilizes your body's natural processes to direct this energy, so it can cause a strain on the wearer, even as it heals him. Our mystical lore tells us, you have heard whispers of a legendary glaive known as the mighty Calastor. Not particularly skilled or smart, Calastor's legend lives to this day, primarily because his career as a warrior spanned to the end of his days at a very ripe old age. Even as his hair fell out and his limbs turned thin and frail, Calastor was still fighting on the front lines as some of the most famous battles of the Sagus Protectorate. Now it appears you have found at least part of the secret to his story. Yeah, I'll put that. Healing skill. Well, you know what? I'm gonna give this Kindiru thing to Eritus. And I'm gonna put this on. I have the mirror casters. It's pretty sweet too. You might as well use these bonded items. Oh, this is might. Okay. Well, here's our usable items, our consumables, actually. You can only use one bonded item. Well, at some point, I guess we'll find one for him. Alright, this is... Yeah, if we want to get new members.
Yes.
Like teleported to us. So these guys.
Find them. Something to do.
Are they gonna know what we did? Any different.
Of course.
Now I want to go look up the graves again. The two Cai'sul graves.
Go.
Graves.
Yes, child.
Enter the code for choice tomb. Okay, he leveled up. Choi stirs in your mind. She sees what you see. You feel what she feels. But you cannot put a name to her emotion. Acceptance of her fate, perhaps? Or resignation? Or pain at her parents' pain? Beneath that, something else. Comprehension of the death of their love for her. Revealed only when she was stripped away. She depth, not death. She whispers inaudibly. Then you're alone again, in your mind. Alright. Increase. Well, that's gotta be useful. Fell swoop. You know what? I'm gonna choose healing. 5 bonus points per level healed when any healing ability or item is used. Sweet, so we got healing. We can use that for Tiber next whenever we can do that. See, I've got healing. I guess when I heal somebody, it's not when you're being healed.
Yes.
Ronos Cai'sul's tomb.
Yes, now.
Cool. Through your eyes, Troy looks at her father's marker. Sadness seeps out of her into your mind. The realization that this shadow is all that remains of him. And then a revelation shakes her, and she speaks to you softly. The marker is all that remains out there. But he's not gone. Not truly. Just changed. Then you're alone again in your mind. I can replay these things. Oh, wait.
All right.
Well, did I even choose this? A host of images. This is display likenesses. A host of images appear, a series of pictures collected from the lifetime of a handsome, driven man, in various poses, as a baby learning to walk, as a child exploring the shell of some sort of crashed flying vessel, as a young man studiously dissecting a Numenera tool, as a father, as a widower. Through the course of years, his face grows more haggard and rugged, but he retains a youthful charm. He looks nothing like the Ronos Cai'sul you encountered outside in the valley.
Ready.
Hold on, I want to make sure I did this. 5143. Because I restored the game at some point. So I don't know if I, went back to before I did that. 5143? Five. One. Four. That's where Oddworld is, right? We know that. Okay. Never mind.
Yes, now.
I guess we hold on to that thing forever? Maybe if we have ransacked his stuff against his wishes, then it would have disappeared? I don't know, because I don't want to do that. So we're going to back to the first cast-off's tomb.
On it.
On it. So, before I leave, I just want to see if anyone has anything new to say now that we've accomplished this task. These guys will ignore us. I was missing someone. Alright, Lady Anch. So this is for intellect. Want to get this wisp thing? Sure. I can actually physically hold that, because I can hold 4. I have 169 left. And I'm going to sell this sword. It is pretty sweet. I mean, I would give it to one of them, but theirs are slightly better at least. See? She doesn't have spray flesh. So as soon as we find spray flesh, anyone selling it, we need to get that stuff. I have 3 of these and 1 of the good ones. And Calistis has 1 of the good ones, and that's it. Give 1 to him. Okay. Tiber, that is. Okay. So wait. Right. We need to get stronger, they said, before we go there, so I'm gonna bet we're not done yet. Find help for Aratus, that's it. I've answered all of Adiris' questions, and she will finally allow me to use the mirror caster and speak to Mazoff. She pointed out that changing the past means anything could change, so I should prepare myself and tell her when I'm ready. Hopefully this will all be over soon.
Happy to help.
So So next episode, we're going to tell her we're ready and go into the mirror looking for Mazov. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next one when we do that stuff. And enduring, cross strong.